Alright guys, welcome back. We are now on part 36 of Final Fantasy V Advance. When we last left off, we had just defeated the mighty Shinryu and the fearsome Omega, the two super bosses in the original game. So now, we are going to be making our way into the bonus dungeon and the horrors that that entails. First things first, though, we need to actually, you know, get a party set up that can potentially not horribly die in that place. Alright, so and now, the enemies, ideally you'll want to have a team that is almost completely, if or that is mostly, if not completely maxed out. If not, you can still get away with just like learner team, but you really want to max out as much as possible, basically. Alright. Let's see. Put you on summon. And you can stay barred for now, but you definitely are not having time magic. The predictability is the alternate Oracle ability. It works like the Condemn ability, only it's random. And it affects everyone and can be good or bad for the entire attacking party. You could do a full heal to everybody, or it could instantly kill everybody. It's a not a smart thing to ever use. The third ability the Oracle has, however, is Ability Points Up, which doubles the amount of ability points you learn or you earn when you at the end of each battle. So that is actually very useful. All right, so let's go ahead and save. And if you remember, the bonus area is right down here. Now, since we changed all our stats around, let's go ahead and take a quickie nap so that we can reset health. Because free inns are a wonderful, wonderful thing. All right, let's go. So we can't open that one just yet. Well, we can't go that way anymore. That's still sealed, so let's go through the third door. Ooh, convenient save point is convenient. This is probably about to get horrifically bad. Oh! Grenades. They're not too bad. So, welcome to the Sealed Temple. There are a number of... Unlike the Lunar Ruins in Final Fantasy IV, it is not random. However, it is... The map for this area is massive and sprawling, and is quite extensive. Because you will be going through pretty much every type of area in the game, facing enemies from all over the game, as well as some new ones. And there, it also has its fair share of bosses and super bosses. Alright. Alright, so Lena has mastered the Bard class. Let's go ahead and put her on Dancer so that we can get her the ability to wear ribbons while she is in Mimic mode. Whoops. Yeah, the chicken knife does that. Oh yay, blast shot. I already maxed out on that. Actually, what am I doing? Yeah, I've almost got the chicken knife maxed out on attack power. Few more bits of running away and it should be, but we're not going to worry about that just yet. Well, as long as I have the wealth to spend, I will make them drown. And I'm out of money. Unfortunate. Well, good to know these enemies are vulnerable to instant death. No idea what these guys' levels are. So basically, what the dancer has four different dances. It has the Jitterbug, the Mystery Waltz, the Sword Dance, and oh geez, what was the last one? Can't remember off the top of my head. But Jitterbug is an MP steal. Jitterbug is a HP steal, similar to the similar to the drain spell. Jitterbug is an MP steal, similar to Osmos. Sword Dance causes the character to attack at 4x attack power. And then the final one is a confusion attack. I currently have Lena equipped with two pieces of equipment that are supposed to cause Sword Dance to appear more often. It's hit or miss. So basically, just explore the area thoroughly, like with the other post-game dungeons in 4 and 6 Advance. There is a massive amount of just awesome equipment just lying around for you to find. Looks like the paralyze wore off. Got a high potion. Yay. Fortunately, Lena's sweet dance moves completely wreck you, and I'm going the wrong way. Okay, Lena, I need you to not drain their MP. I need you to, you know, sword dance them to death. Ooh, Thunder Rod. thing I have plenty of potions. Well. Huh. It's the Nutkin family. That thing has a lot of health. Why does it have a lot of health? It needs to have less health. There we go. I have poison. Why do I have poison? Okay, these guys are a little violent. And by a little, I mean excessively. And it gets 2 attacks per turn. Awesome. Okay, goal is to just unload on these damn things. When we can hit them. Oh great, Incisor also inflicts poison, that's why. Lena, please stop stealing MP and start actually, you know, inflicting damage. There we go. Let's not deal with this. All right. So, let's see. Ooh, there's treasure over there. Okay, normal enemies again. Yay. And I'm out of money. Well, Jitterbug would have been more useful if, you know, we had actual HP loss to regain, but whatever. Okay, this thing needs to die, like, right now. There we go. Alright. Oh, that's what I thought was going to happen. Oh, hey. Takes me over to this treasure chest, which has something for my chemists. I suppose that's better than nothing. Bartz, your accuracy is terrible. If I remember correctly, I think this was one of the enemies from the Phoenix Tower. That was a lot of damage. It needs to not hit so hard. Really don't want to waste Bahamut. Why is this thing still alive? That's not very useful. Wow. 25 ability points. That's pretty good. So that is definitely not the enemy from Phoenix Tower that I thought it was. Oh, well. Great. That was just a big waste. I don't really want to fight this thing again. Actually, let me see. Where are you? Killed you once, so you should show up in here. There we go, Villa. Or Villia. 19,000 HP. Absorbs the rare elements. It's not immune to anything, though, so we can actually... Actually, no. What's its level? Come on. Where are you again? There we go. 27. So you can be hit with level 3 flare. Interesting. Well, let's see how much damage level 3 flare does. Lena, I need you to actually damage, please. Well, you're not immune to instant death, which means when Odin decides to cooperate, he can just chop you in half. Oh, I see. One of these four goes to that center platform. And I whiffed. While that 25 AP is really tempting, I'd rather not. Oh, movers! Oh, right, they're undead. Movers are considered undead, so any weapon that has a potential instant death attack, like the Assassin's Dagger, will instantly kill them and then cause them to respawn at full health. Let's see, I think they have a multiple of 3. Nope. Also, the weird thing about movers is you have essentially 2 rounds to defeat them. If you do not kill them within those 2 rounds, then the battle immediately ends, no matter what. Alright, cool. Lena has mastered the art of the dance, so let's go ahead and start her on the path of the cannoneer. So the Cannoneer, as I mentioned before, is like an offensive version of the Chemist. It has the ability to mix the different shot types with certain items in order to inflict, or in order to do attacks, basically. Alright, so we tried number three. Number three didn't work. Let's try number four. Where does this go? Big whiff. Okay, that's not what I thought it was. Must be one of its later abilities. Hey, Bart's actually hit her for once. Good job, Bart's. Ooh, we even got the rare drop. Those angel rings are worth about 50,000 zen or 50,000 gil, so saves us from having to buy one later. Alright, let's try the second one, because we've already tried the left or the right two. And where do you take me? Success! Alright, you better be worth it. I'll take it. Oh. Yeah, they really don't have anything worthwhile. Or, I don't really have any worthwhile blue magics. Oh, actually, I think these guys are vulnerable to Odin. And I'll try casting Odin next time Krill's turn rolls around. Oh, nope. And now you're going to get to see what happens when you don't kill all the movers before they get two turns. Or not. Okay, cool. Samurai has been mastered. Let's put Bartz on Gladiator. give him an actual attack class. Yeah, the gladiator can equip anything. Well, any warrior class weapon, basically. She needs to get a few more. As I mentioned before, the finisher attack is unique to the... or is either a miss, which is a failure, it is a critical attack, which is basically double damage, or it is an elemental strike, unique to the different characters. Bartz is wind, Lena is water, Krill is earth, and Ferris is fire. As it is an elemental strike, it is subject to enemy weaknesses and resistances, so you gotta be careful about that. Got a boss. Alright. Well, this should do. Meet the Guild Turtle. This is actually a boss that you can fight earlier in the game. There was the cave near... Baal Castle on the way to the Big Bridge. There was a certain room that you could fight the Guild Turtle in. And the Guild Turtle retaliates every single attack with the ability Turtle, which inflicts poison and which deals a decent amount of physical damage and inflicts poison, so it's a pain in the neck. It's also weak to ice, which I don't think I actually have a ice element attack available. Oh, I do. Let's see how this does. That was a waste. Wow. I'm better off just whacking it with the Ragnarok. Let's see if we can hit with Deathclaw. Nope. Oh, yeah, it also absorbs all non-ice elements. I forgot about that. Whoops. So whatever little bit of damage I had done a moment ago has been completely negated. Actually, can I run away from this thing? Because I need to... Nope, of course not. Alright, this is bad. is. Okay. Actually, I do have something I can do. And that is bust out the magic lamp. So, what the magic lamp does is it summons your... or it calls a summon. Wow, that was really bad. But it calls your summons from the last learned summon all the way down to the first. It will not call Phoenix, however. This is probably my best bet, is just cast 1,000 needles at it until it dies. Because that seems to be the best way to deal damage to it. This thing's defense is so ridiculously high. Oh, for want of a remedy. Apparently, Turtle also inflicts blind. Oh, and apparently blind persists over being dead. That's lovely. Fortunately, rapid fire ignores accuracy and just guarantees 4 hits. Friggin', really? I definitely came here with the 100% incorrect party configuration. I really should have brought my white mage along. Or better yet, a Spellblade dual wielder with rapid fire. I could have just set Blazaga Spellblade and just completely wrecked him in a single turn. Oh, damn it. I was hoping you would ignore Krill. Oh, hey, she actually hit it. Haha! Oh, that took way too long. And the worst part is that stupid thing was only worth 3 ability points. So yeah, we got the Grand Helm, which gives a pretty decent defense. Not the best. The Thornlet is still the best. Is still the best helmet, even though it has the permanent sap effect. Oh yeah, that's right. I forgot. I turned off flea. All right, let's see if we can find a save point. Oh, hey, there's treasure over there. All right, come on, let me get out of here. Alright. I killed one, so might as well finish the fight. Now, one nifty thing about gladiators is one of their later innate abilities is called long range, which basically permanently gives them the ability to deal full damage from the front or back row. One good thing about having a Berserker around is that you can use them for Heal Mule. You just have to remember to reset their equipment after you do so. If you can steal from one of these guys, do it. Because they have some good stuff too. Hey, thanks. Dark Matter is not actually the item. They have a secondary item. I'll pull up their bestiary, I'm sure, after this fight and show it. Once this thing actually decides, you know, die. thanks. You weren't confused that time. Okay. So, where is it? There we go. Stingray. Yeah, you can steal the Rune Blade from it, which is a really powerful... it's a pretty powerful sword. And then also, it occasionally drops the Dragon's Whisker, which is the most powerful whip in the game. Of course, the drop is incredibly rare. It's like a 1 in 256 at best. Alright. That's enough with fighting these idiots. I need to set Flea. Come on. Come on, these are just grunt enemies. Great, it's immune to gravity. So now the question is, what's going to happen first? Am I going to kill the enemies, or are they or am I going to run away? The answer is yes. Another shuriken. That's good. You look like a boss. Alright. So let's actually, you know, set up the party to be able to, you know, not die to a stupid powerful boss. Oh, wait, you haven't mastered. You haven't mastered Dancer yet. That's annoying. Lena has Master Dancer. Why isn't it letting her equip ribbons? That's bothersome. Alright. I really dislike you right now. Okay, so thankfully we don't actually have to fight that stupid thing. So we need to find a behemoth. Oh, we can't teleport out of this place. Ah. I have no MP left. That's unfortunate. One thing I can do, however, is Mimic, because Mimic doesn't use MP. Nice. There we go. That's my last antidote. Because of course it is. Kind of curious as to what happens when a non-gladiator class pulls off the finisher. Right. Unfortunately, it keeps the same targets. Oh, hey, let Krill do the Earth attack. Interesting. And we need to stop doing that. Because this thing absorbs elements. You know what? Well, that didn't work. So, we're just going to unload on this guy. And this is why the quick spell is broken. Fortunately for the game, you can't actually nest them. But considering I just did 4 summons of Bahamut for the price of 2, So now we need to make our way back out of this place. Oh, wait, she absorbs holy crap. Oh, and she absorbs wind, that's right. Ah, jeez. That was. Oh, and now Lena's out of MP. We're good at this game, folks. We really are. Fortunately, Krill's mimic still allows her to do the double flare. And of course, she fails. Well, at the very least, I am getting a nice chunk of money. She does not absorb fire. Oh, holy crap. Run away, run away, run away. No, dies to a meteor. Well, multiple meteors. No! What? the friggin' heck. That was really dirty. Great, they're immune to instant death. Why isn't it dead? Oh, I should have just dual casted Phoenix. That was excessive. Wrong way. Why are these things set up like Tonberries? Poison. I'm sure we're going to have to unlock that at some point and fight that guy. Okay, well, we are running away quickly back to the convenient save point that is convenient right over here. Because we kind of need to restock. On everything. Well, let's find out. Yep. We are back to our ship. And conveniently enough, it puts us right over by the village of the Phantom Village. So we can run right on in and spend all of this ridiculous amount of money that we've just earned. Which, admittedly, is not all that much. We're going to need to actually stock up on ailment healing items, especially if we have a bad habit of not bringing white mages along. Alright, now we can blow the rest on some elixirs. All right. Back to the mysterious area we go. I'm going to take a quick break here. I'll be back in a few minutes, and we will explore some more of the new area. So, see you guys in a little bit.